National Parks, Wyoming and Utah. Hi everyone, and welcome back to our National Park series. Today, we'll continue to look at the national parks in the western region of the United States, as we celebrate and explore the unique landforms, ecosystems, and natural beauty of the spectacular national parks in Wyoming and Utah. Let's begin our visit with the most famous of all of Yellowstone's features, the Old Faithful geyser. The word geyser is typically used to describe any hot spring that ejects a column of steaming water into the air on a periodic basis. Old Faithful is a geyser that has earned its name because you can always predict when it's going to erupt again, and it won't disappoint. You have to stand at a distance to watch Old Faithful in action, because you're watching 5,000 gallons of blistering, hot, boiling water shooting straight up into the air. Each eruption lasts anywhere from 2 to 5 minutes and is a once-in-a-lifetime experience to behold. Over to the east of Bryce and Zion is our next and equally striking park in Utah, called Arches National Park. It is sometimes thought to be the most feature-packed of all of Utah's southern parks. Imagine riding or hiking through a desert complete with hundreds of red, orange, golden arches. All of these arches are made by nature in all of their glorious high desert sandstone color. As we ride or hike along, we can spot the names of the different arches. See if you can figure out why they were given their names. Here's Delicate Arch, which happens to be the best known arch in the world. Landscape Arch, the largest in the world. And here, the Double Arch. This one, the Double O Arch. Tower Arch. Cove Arch. Eye of the Whale Arch. Broken Arch. Partition Arch. Pine Tree Arch. Tunnel Arch, Skyline Arch, and Turret Arch. You may be wondering, why are these wonders of nature created exactly? Why exactly here in Utah? It is, after all, the world's highest density of arches. We hope you've been fascinated with our visit to Arches National Park and all the other parks we saw today, and that you enjoy learning how nature created these unique forms. We hope you'll join us again soon as we continue to explore the highlights of the many other national parks across the country. See you then!